The bill passed in the US Senate makes animal cruelty a federal felony, punishable by fines and up to 7 years in prison. Until recently, the federal law only banned animal fighting and criminalized cruelty towards animals solely if the act was recorded on camera for purposes of selling the video. Yet, it never explicitly banned the acts of torture themselves. Though all 50 states have laws regarding animal cruelty, such an all-encompassing federal law would be the first in the country's history. Animal rights advocates welcome the change, among them the Humane Rescue Alliance, one of the largest such organizations in the United States.
So the PACT Act gives federal law enforcement the tools necessary to pursue egregious acts of animal cruelty. And here in the district, oftentimes cases can affect interstate commerce because we're so close to the state lines of Virginia and Maryland. Our officers investigate thousands of cases of animal cruelty per year, and we have had cases where if this law had been in place, then proper justice would have been served.
The new measure will prohibit any conduct in which one or more living non-human mammals, birds, reptiles, or amphibians is purposely crushed, burned, drowned, suffocated, impaled, or otherwise subjected to serious bodily injury. The perpetrators will be held criminally liable. According to the FBI, animal cruelty is linked to violent crimes against human beings as well. It was only in 2016 that the FBI started to keep records of all animal cruelty acts, and representatives of the Humane Rescue Alliance believe thousands of such acts of cruelty take place every year. However, not everyone is happy with the bill. Many believe there are still many loopholes that can be used by perpetrators.
The only thing that disappoints me is it's become customary to include waivers or exemptions under these acts for such things as agricultural husbandry and hunting and science and even slaughtering animals for food.
The next step is for President Trump to sign the PACT Act into law. Maxim Moskalkiv for VOA News, Washington.